Good morning, I am Devasena. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about study of electrocardiogram. This topic comes under the medical electronics subject, unit 1. Let us discuss about ECG, that is the electrocardiogram. Heart is a muscle that works like a pump for blood. The heart contraction creates an action potential which initiates electrical current. The different electrical potentials between different parts of the body can cause cardiogram. The recording of the electrical activity associated with the function of the heart is known as electrocardiogram. ECG is a quasi-periodical rhythmically repeating signal synchronized by the function of heart which acts as bioelectric events. The waveforms thus recorded have been standardized in terms of amplitude and phase relationships, and any deviation from this would reflect the presence of abnormality that is present in the heart. The working of the heart can be compared with the oscillator that is present in the electronic circuits. Let us see the cross-sectional view of human heart. This is the cross-sectional view. Here, various parts of the heart is being indicated. Let us discuss about sinoatrial node. It is also called as SA node. The heart has its own system for generating and conducting action potentials through a complex change of ionic concentration across the cell membrane. Sinoatrial node initiates the electrical activity of the heart. It acts as primary pacemaker of the heart. It is located in the top atrium near the entry of the vena cava. It is 25 to 30 millimeter in length and 2 to 5 centimeter in thickness. Let us see the ECG waveform. This is the ECG waveform representation. ECG waveform comprises of P wave, PR interval, QRS complex, QT interval, ST segment, and T wave. Let us discuss about P wave. Under normal conditions, electrical activity is spontaneously generated by the SC node, the physiological pacemaker. This electrical impulse is propagated throughout the right and left atria, stimulating the myocardium of the atria to contract. The conduction of the electrical impulse throughout the atria is seen on the ECG as the P wave. Internodal tracks. As the electrical activity is spreading throughout the atria, it travels via specialized pathways known as internodal tracks from the AC node to the AV node. The P wave is the electrical signature of the current that causes atrial depolarization. Both the left and right atria contract simultaneously. Its relationship to QRS complexes determine the presence of heart block. Irregular or absent P waves may indicate arrhythmia. The shape of the P waves may indicate atrial problems. Let us start discussing about PR interval. PR interval or AV node bundles. The AV node functions as a critical delay in the conduction system. Without this delay, the atria and ventricles would contract at the same time and blood would not flow effectively from the atria to the ventricles. The delay in the AV node forms much of the PR segment on the ECG and part of atrial repolarization be represented by PR segment. Let us start discussing about the QRS complex. The origin of QRS complex is from Purkinje fibers or ventricular myocardium. The two bundle branches tap out to produce numerous Purkinje fibers which stimulate individual groups of myocardial cells to contract. The spread of electrical activity through the ventricular myocardium produces the QRS complex on the ECG. The QRS complex corresponds to the current that causes contraction of the left and right ventricles, which is much more forceful than that of the atria and involves more muscle mass, thus resulting in a greater ECG deflection. The Q wave, when present, represents the small horizontal, that is left to right, current as the action potential travels through the interventricular septum. Very wide and deep Q waves do not have a septal origin but indicate myocardial infraction that involves the full depth of myocardium and has left a scar. Let us discuss about the abnormalities that is present in the QRS complex. Bundle branch block when wide. Ventricular origin of the tachycardia, ventricular hypertrophy or other ventricular abnormalities. The complexes are often small in pericardites or pericardial effusion. Let us discuss about R and S wave. The R and S waves indicate the spread of the action potential along the ventricular myocardium itself. Let us discuss about ST segment. The ST segment connects the QRS complex and the T wave. ST segment elevation or ST segment depression may indicate coronary ischemia or myocardial infraction. Now we discuss about the T wave, that is ventricular repolarization. The last event of the cycle is the repolarization of the ventricles. In most leads, the T wave is positive. An impulse, that is an action potential that originates from the SE node at a rate of 60 to 100 beats per minute, is known as normal sinus rhythm. If SE nodal impulses occur at a rate less than 60 beats per minute, the heart rhythm is known as sinus bradycardia. If SE nodal impulse occur at a rate exceeding 100 beats per minute, the consequent rapid heart rate is sinus tachycardia. These conditions are not necessarily bad symptoms, however. Trained athletes, for example, usually show heart rates slower than 60 beats per minute when not exercising. So far we have discussed about the characteristics of ECG waveform. Let us now discuss about the uses of ECG. It is the gold standard for the evaluation of cardiac arrhythmias. The 12-lead ECG stands at the center of risk stratification for patients with suspected acute myocardial infraction. It can be useful for detecting electrolyte disturbances, that is potassium or calcium. Allows the detection of conduction abnormalities, that is right and left bundle branch block. As a screening tool for ischemic heart disease during an cardiac stress test, can suggest non-cardiac disease, example pulmonary embolism or hypothermia.